Yeah, this morning we're over at the Everton Red Triangle Boxing Gym in Liverpool, and I'm pleased to say I'm joined by Conor Butler, young professional prospect on his way up. How's it going, mate? It's good to see you.
Good to see you, Chris. Nice to see you, yeah. Just in the gym, just taking over a bit.
Buzzing this morning as well, isn't it? They've got a bit of sparring going on there.
My lads are back in the gym. It's great to see. It's good to be back.
Good. What have you been doing, you know, during lockdown? Have you been keeping yourself busy?
Just working more, and I've got a job in a factory, so I've just been working in there, doing overtime and stuff, and just still taking over training, waiting for a fight to pop up. It's hard, but at the same time, it's the game that we're in. We've got to keep going and keep doing it.
Recently, some of your gym mates, Brad, Andy and Nick, they signed over with Frank Warren, so they were out just before lockdown, July I think. You're waiting for some news yourself, and there's nothing sort of in the pipeline that you can speak about. Well, there is things in the pipeline, but nothing you can speak about. But there's a few options going forward.
Yeah.
Hopefully you hear something soon and you can
Definitely.
Get yourself...
Been told some news about potential fights coming up to the end of the year and next year, but it's just taking it by ear because of the circumstances that everyone's under at the minute. Everyone's under tremendous pressure with the COVID-19 situation and things like that. It's just about staying fit, keeping me head on the job, and whatever comes my way, take it with both hands, jump at the chance.
Now, we'll talk about your record then, and you wasn't 100% sure of what it is, but have you had time to reflect on your career and look back at some of the videos, you know, during this time, and you know, see how far you have come really in that time?
Yeah, sure. I remember... It's funny because after every fight we sit down and we analyse them with ball about things to work on, things that we could have done differently in the fight or things that went well, whatever sort of happened. Each fight's different, as we all know, but it's funny when I look back to my first fight where I was really excited on my pro debut and jumping at the chance, trying to get the knockout and things like that. And you can see how much you've grown from each fight within a couple of months in between each fight that we were having. It's funny to see the way I was in my debut to in my last fight where I was so controlled and calm and just focused on the job. At the time of my debut, the emotions and the event got the best of me. I was a bit excited and trying to force the work a little bit. But as I've grown as a pro with the lads in the gym who are experienced and just learning on the job, and when you get into the ring, it's all about taking all of that you've done in the gym to when you get into fight night. When you're there, it's just about improvising and doing everything you do in the gym, in the ring, and just getting it right on the night. That's it. Don't let anything get the best of you outside the ring. And that's just what I've learned to. Well, I'm still learning now, everyone. You learn every day in the sport, but I'm still learning on nights of fights and things like that, like how to deal with certain things and stay calm in the ring, under pressure and things like that. It's just a learning curve, the whole thing.
The experience you get as you go along,
With the lads in the gym, they're all experienced. Some of them have had more fights than me, so further down the line, you get little tips off them how to deal with certain situations. And it's great to have. It's really good to have people who've been there and done it, and you're learning with them as you're progressing through your career.
I've known you for a while. I've been coming here now for a few years, so I've seen you kind of coming through. There was always a real aura about you all, and very talented, but I think the wider people in boxing now are getting to see that, and since you signed over with Frank, but there is that real buzz about this gym, and a lot of people who know what they're talking about are saying there's going to be a crop of fighters coming from there who are the next, you know, the next stars of Liverpool. It has got that, hasn't it? And you're feeling that in the gym. What's it like to be part of
that? It's funny really, because we've all started on smaller shows, and you get people who are like, people who talk about boxing and are like, oh, this and that, and then you mention the likes of like Nicholas, Andrew and Brad, and amongst the other fighters in the gym, and people are like, oh, who are they? And just because they haven't seen them on Sky Sports, everyone's like, oh, they might not be anyone sort of thing. But then when you actually see them on Sky and what they're doing and what the amount of talent that's in this gym, it's funny because we tell people and people are like, oh, but if they actually came in and seen for themselves, they know that there's something good going on in here. With Paul at the helm and all of us coming through, it's gonna be an amazing future to see in the next 3 to 4 years when everyone's got the chance on the big Sky Sports bills and stuff like that. That's what everyone wants, the televised fights. But they're all to come down the line. You do your learning in your small all shows, and then from there you just progress. You get your chance to show what you're about, and we'll all be taking that with both hands and showing everyone what we are about.
brilliant to be a part of as well. And you mentioned Paul there, he's been orchestrating this and bringing us all through, and you know, he's on the cusp, let's say, of something really, really good. Paul's a big influence on you all.
Definitely, even outside the gym as well, he's always making sure everyone's okay and what everyone's been up to and things like that. The boxing, he's never met a man in my life that knows more about boxing than Paul. He's an amazing coach. He coaches us all individually on all little things that we need to work on. It's great, it's bosh. Couldn't be in a better place.
And we got to mention Peter McGrail's amazing qualifying for the Olympics. I mean, I'd speaking to Paul there, he was saying he's won a medal in every major tournament he's been in except for the Olympics. Yeah. And now he's there, and that would really be the icing on the cake, wouldn't
I'm sure he will as well. He's phenomenal. It's when we're sparring Peter, and it's like you get in there with someone who can read your mind. It's crazy. The lad's got superpowers, I think. But even his younger brother Joseph, he's an amazing fighter. You can see that they look the exact same. They come in the gym the other day and I was like, Joe's grown, and I'm like, bloody hell, Joe, you look like Peter, laughing about it. But he's some fight in him, and to be sparring with the likes of him and the other lads, it's unbelievable. You can't ask for more.
Yeah. And we said there, there's nothing in the pipeline for you at the moment, but you're in the gym, you're training, you're keeping ticking over, and hopefully we can start getting more fights on shows. The smaller hall shows can start coming again to give you your bread and butter learning, if you like, and hopefully you get that big call and you're getting some of the big shows as well. But if you're keeping positive about the
definitely
situation.
Yeah, it's just it's the sport that we're in, boxing. Some fighters don't know when the next fight is, and it's important to stay mentally strong and focused and determined, just knowing that somewhere down the line that chance is going to come. And you've just got to take it with both hands. You've always got to be ready. Even when you haven't got fights like myself, like lines up in the pipeline or whatever, don't know when my next fight is, but I know that when it is there, I'm going to be ready for it, because I'm taking over and I'm staying disciplined and I'm ready for it. I'm ready to go.
I wish you all the best, mate. It's great to see you anyway, and see you positive, and all the lads in the gym buzzing again, back open. Anyone who's not watched Conor Butler, look out for this lad, because he really is... one to watch.
Just want to say, hope everyone's well on the COVID and all that, and hope everyone's staying safe, and just hopefully this world gets back to normal, the quicker the better.
Absolutely, mate. Is there anyone else you want to shout out before we go?
Just all
my
sponsors, really. Everyone who stuck by me through lockdown. I know times have been hard and things like that. I just hope all of them are, I've spoke to them all anyway, they're all fine, but just with times like this, these are the people that are helping me with my career, and without them it wouldn't be possible. And with this situation with the COVID-19 and the coronavirus and all that, it has been hard on them. So I'm just making sure I'm giving them the opportunity to like get business or get work or whatever they need. So thanks to everyone, and thanks to all my supporters as well, all checking in on me and seeing what's going on. I'm sure I'll have some good news for you all soon. But I hope everyone's staying well and staying safe.
Great to see you, mate. God bless.
Thanks for that, Chris. See you soon.